Friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the tips and the preparation strategy as well as what can CBSE 12th compartment exam failed candidate can do. Okay, so yesterday, that is on 18th of July 2019, CBSE have announced the 12th compartment results of CBSE 2019. So the students who have failed in compartment exam as well, this video is exclusively for you guys, because first of all, it's fine to have few backlogs. It's fine, don't be depressed or don't get any negative thoughts. Please be confident, you are going to rock this exam in the future. So now let's see what can you do now. Okay, so the CBSE conducts the compartment exam every July, in every July, and after the student fails in July, he or she has the chance to attend in the same compartment exam for 12th in 2020 of March. So in 2020 March or April, the CBSE conducts the exam again, so you can then happily apply for the exam. So, and the second thing which I would like to tell you is, you have lot of time, so please don't waste time. From now, right from now, start your preparation. So CBSE gives 5 chances for the students who have failed. So it might be 10th or 12th or 11th. So you have more chances to prove yourself, so be confident. Now let's see the preparation strategy of passing in the compartment exam in the coming future, and then let's see the tips. So coming to the preparation strategy, first what you need to do is the subjects which you have failed in, it might be one or two, like the backlogs which you have, so concentrate on those subjects right from now, okay? Because you have more than 6 months where you can easily crack any of the exam, okay? Let it be a difficult exam, or let it be the tough paper, let it be you're so weak at that subject, but still you have lot of time to prove yourself, to easily pass in the exam. So what you need to do is, first of all, the subjects which you failed. So for example, let's think you have failed in 2 exams, okay? So first of all, prepare those 2 subjects according to a schedule and according to your timetable, okay? So I'm not asking you to study 24/7. So out of 24 hours, at least for example, let's, we are considering 2 subjects as failed subjects, taking an example of 2 subjects. So prepare the timetable in such a way that you read 1.5 hour subject 1, and then take half an hour to say 40 minutes break, and then shift to the second subject and read continuously for 1.5 hour, okay? First subject, break, second subject, again break, first subject. So keep switching the subjects so that even you will not feel bored, you will not feel bored while preparation, okay? So preparing the same subject, preparing the same topic the whole day gives you monotony, you will feel bored. So that's why what you need to do is, you have to start preparing a subject, take little break, and then switch to second subject, take little break, and then the first subject, vice versa, okay? So, and what you need to do is, that is the preparation strategy, and prepare a schedule in such a way that it gives most of the priority for the topics which you are very weak at. For example, in the particular subject, you are very poor or very weak at a particular topic, okay? Then you should prepare your timetable in such a way that you should give the most of the time for those particular topics which you are very weak at, okay? So that you'll have enough time for the preparation of those weak topics, and you can easily score more marks as well as you can easily pass in the exam, okay? So coming to the next preparation strategy, the continuation of the preparation strategy is that follow the standard books, okay? So you'll have the standard books follow them, because what you write in the exam really matters and it makes you pass easily in the exam. So first of all, you have to follow the standard books. Don't prepare only important topics. You should also prepare the topics which are repeatedly asked in the exam as well, and also the topics which your teacher or the faculty guides you to prepare, because completely based upon, like, if you are completely based only upon the important topics, it is a risk again. So also I suggest you to prepare few more topics additionally to the important topics also. So this is the preparation strategy. Now let's see what are the tips which you can follow to easily crack any exam, okay, coming to the Cbse. So first of all, after preparing the timetable, make your mind, okay, fix in your mind that you have the mission to crack this exam anyhow, okay. Don't let your brain divert, okay. So most of the students, they don't follow timetable. You should not be like that. You should stick to your schedule, and you wanna rock this exam, okay. So stick to your timetable. And the second tip is that collect last 10 years of papers, okay, the question papers, the previous year's question papers, the main exam papers, compartment exam papers, and all of last 10 years of CBSE class 12th or class 10th, if you're a 10th student, go with class 10th, else class 12th, okay. So collect all the papers of last few 10 years previous papers, and then start reading those papers as well, okay. So mostly 20-30% of the questions repeat every year, okay. So this tip really helps you to easily pass in this exam. So okay, please collect the last 10 year previous year's papers and keep revising them daily. So what you need to do is you have to take the paper and start studying the paper, okay. So the question related answer, such like that, complete as many papers as possible, because you have 6 months time, so you need not worry. And the third important tip is that time management is really important, because in exam you'll have a particular time and you have particular answers. So if you're stuck with the particular question, if you are taking so much time to write a particular answer in the exam, or if you are wasting time by glancing at other people in the exam center, you're going to run out of the time. So time management is important. So also make sure you have good writing and good presentation, because though you have the knowledge, the person, the examiner who is correcting your paper, the evaluator who is correcting your paper, should feel impressed after looking at your paper, after seeing at your paper, okay. So the writing skills, the presentation skills really matters a lot, okay. Though you have knowledge, like I have seen lots and lots of people who have plenty knowledge but still fails in exam because of their poor handwriting, poor presentation skills. So in such kind of exams, in such kind of exam patterns, presentation really helps, okay. First impression is the best impression. I think you even know this statement, which is very famous. So once the evaluator looks at your paper, he or she should feel impressed, okay. So work on your writing skills, put a timer and start writing the answer, and analyze your writing skills, okay. So if you are writing fast, is your handwriting getting worse? So analyze those things, okay. And keep and coming to the presentation skills, the tips are, if you have a particular diagram, draw it with neat sharpened pencil, okay. Few students are really lazy, they go with pen, they go with the scratchings. No, don't do that. So you know what you need to do is you have to take a neatly sharp pencil and draw a neat sketch of the diagram, which whatever the diagram they asks you, and then draw a neatly bordered marks, like, you know, you have to draw lines after each and every answer or after each and every problem after solving it. And the third tip is coming to the headings. Okay, like, you know, if it is a long answer, start the heading with introduction. Okay, introduction of the topic, underline it, like write it with the blue pen and underline it with black pen or vice versa. Okay, and then write in points and start writing the answer in points. Okay, so most of the students write in the paragraph. So when you write in the paragraph, what happens is the evaluator will not have so much time to read every point or every word in your paragraph. Okay, so it's not even interesting to read the paragraphs, right? So what you need to do is you just need to put the answer in the points form and present neatly, present in the attractive manner. Okay, so put the arrows, use the like, you know, little lines, and use the points, and, you know, make it attractive and present the answer in the form of points. Okay, so, and the next presentation tip which I would like to give you is coming to the mathematics. What you need to do is you have to like, you know, while solving any problem, if you have any like, you know, the formula which is related to that solution, write the formula in the right side and just make it in a box. Okay, just write the formula and surround it with a rectangular box with the pencil. And at last, after solving everything, whatever, like, in question, let's assume they've asked you to prove LHS is equal to RHS. Okay, so at last, put the dots and write, hence proved LHS is equal to RHS. Write it with the opposite color pen. Okay, till that, if you solved with a blue pen, and then write the last two lines with the black pen, and even box it with a pencil. Okay, it really helps you to increase your marks, improve your marks, these tips. Okay, so coming to the next preparation tip is that you have to never allow any gadgets to like, you know, distract you. Okay, it's better if you touch your phone less, watch TV less, so concentrate on these subjects. After clearing this exam, you can happily enjoy, celebrate everything. Okay, but till then, please concentrate on studies. And the next tip is that don't let anybody or anything depress you or pull you down. Okay, so it might be relatives or friends or anybody, if they like, you know, start discussing about your failure, or you know, any discussion related to your failure, don't go to depression, or don't take the negative comments, don't take the negative thoughts. You should be confident. You the every question or every comment, for every question and every comment, you should answer with your result. Okay, you're going to rock this exam, trust me. And the fifth tip which I would like to give you is if you have your lecturers, like, or the faculty or the teachers to help you, remember that. So whenever you have any doubt, you have to immediately clarify your doubt with your teacher or your friend or your elder, like, you know, any of the elder. You know, don't carry doubt to the next question or the next day. Okay, solve each and every doubts immediately. Okay, and even Google is there to help you always, so you can happily clarify all your doubts. And the next important tip is that start studying early hours. Okay, try to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning, and you know, if you start at those hours, you'll really feel the calmness, and you will really it really helps you to concentrate in your studies. You know, because there is no disturbance, there's no like, you know, the sounds and all, so it's really peaceful, and you can really concentrate to study well. So start studying at 5 o'clock and make sure you study maximum time possible and sleep early, wake up early. Okay, good policy. And the next tip is that if you have any of your like your relatives or your siblings who are elder to you, you can ask them to guide you. You can ask them to help you for your studies. And if you're not feeling to study by sitting alone, you can ask your parents, one of your parents or your siblings to accompany you. You can ask them to sit along with you and you can happily study. And that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also hit the bell icon for more such videos. I'm going to do more and more tips videos regarding the CBSE and also other boards. And also I'm going to show you a video where you can present your examination paper very well so that you can happily pass in your exam and you can also get more marks because presentation really matters in the board exams as well as the CBSE exam. And also subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share this video with all your friends. Be confident, it's fine to fail in few exams because failure is the first step to success. Okay, remember that all the successful people have failed in their life one or twice. So it's fine to fail. Be confident. Don't let your thoughts become negative. Don't let negative thoughts, don't let the depressions happen. Be confident. It's fine. You're going to pass this exam, trust me. So all the best, subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share. Thanks for watching.